Stop the Delina questioning. Under 21. Look of the day. Cut back. Leave premiere. You're back at Clever Feed. What's up, guys? It's Thursday. I'm Dana Ward with Joslyn Davis, and we've got a really awesome show for you, and it starts right now. Even though Delina has been over for quite some time, it seems like everyone still wants answers about the relationship. Well, maybe that's because they're on and off, and we just can't keep up. And one of the stars is saying no more to answering questions for the wondering public. Good for Selena. The star just straight up rejected all cues related to Justin while at the Dubai Music Week press conference today. And this isn't the first time. Remember back in July when a reporter asked her about Justin's outrageous behavior? And then the feed for her satellite went black.
Don't we get about him? Or what is it that he's not getting out there?
Awkward. I guess that we all should have taken the hint.
What do One Direction, Justin Bieber, Miley Cyrus, and Ariana Grande have in common with an artist named Earl Sweatshirt? They all made the cut for Billboard Magazine 21 Under 21 list. So this list ranks the world's most powerful minors. 1D landed the top spot, with Justin Bieber coming in at number 2, Miley Cyrus right behind him at number 3, and Ariana Grande landing the number 4 spot. Coming in at number 5 is Mr. Earl Sweatshirt. Yes, his last name is Sweatshirt, and yes, he's pretty amazing. So get prepared to hear a ton more from the rapper in the next year. The list is pretty diverse and features some awesome groups too, Emblem 3, Fifth Harmony, and Mindless Behavior. And there's even some K-pop in the mix with Lehigh. But we couldn't help noticing that Demi Lovato and Selena Gomez didn't make the cut. So what's up with this? Yes, both ladies are 21 and the list is 21 under 21, but hello guys, Louis Tomlinson of One Direction is on the list and he's 21, so we're just kind of wondering what's going on here. You guys hit us up and let us know what you think.
And right now it's time for Look of the Day. Sarah Hyland always looks amazing at events and on red carpets. Mm-hmm. And something that you'll notice, her hair is much longer than normal.
Yeah, wasn't it just short last week?
Yes.
Wasn't it like this short?
Yeah, and she's like not trying to hide it. Sometimes people are embarrassed that they're wearing extensions and she is like straight up laying it out for us. She tweeted earlier in the day, photo shoot today, ombre extensions, missing my long hair. So thank you for being honest with us.
Gorgeous look of the day on the heels of the Emmys too, where she also looked absolutely fab.
Great job, Sarah.
Chuck Bass is back.
Yay!
Okay, so that's actually a lie. He's not really back.
But I've got my fingers crossed because I really want this to happen for a future Gossip Girl project.
It could happen. You never know. Never say never, in the words of Justin Bieber. But Ed Westwick is back. He's the actor responsible for one of our all-time favorite TV villains. And just for old time's sake, what do you say, Dana?
Let's throw it back.
Let's throw it back.
I'm Chuck Bass. I'm Chuck Bass.
No. I'm Chuck Bass.
Oh, but I'm sorry. I'm Chuck Bass.
But seriously, Ed Westwick is finally back in action on the big screen, and he's acting alongside Hailee Steinfeld and Douglas Booth in Romeo and Juliet.
And you guys know how this guy plays evil so well, so we had to ask him about it. Check it out.
I just think people see it as evil, I have to say. I mean, a lot of the time I try not to play it too evil, but that's what comes across. As long as people enjoy the performance, I'm very happy.
Misunderstood evil. We love this guy even more.
He's awesome. Mm-hmm. Make sure you guys check out Romeo and Juliet when it hits theaters October 11th.
It is time for Hit Us Up, and lucky for all of us out there, ourselves included.
Yeah.
We're so excited. Glee is returning for season 5 tonight on Fox at 8 p.m. So, I mean, lots to be excited about.
Oh my gosh, we are so excited here at Clever TV, and hopefully you guys are excited too. And we asked you what you are most excited about, and all of you Gleeks answered. Maria Constanza Marin said, everything, the Beatles plus Glee,
What can be better?
I don't know what can be better. I don't know how they're gonna top themselves after this.
Maybe if you throw a peanut butter and jelly sandwich into the mix, would make it even better.
Over the top. Alyssa Mae Bravo said this, the tribute for Corey. I think it goes without saying that this is probably the most talked about moment that people in the media and fans are really looking forward to, but not the only thing, obviously.
Definitely. Up next, Lori Lapuna said, Demi's moments. That's right, she's coming on the show and we finally get to see her guest starring.
So excited. Serena Regeg said, I just can't wait anymore. Well, not to worry, you only have a few more hours. Who knows, in your time zone, it might already be on the East Coast.
Yes. And finally, Clayne Reunites. Love that name, by the way. I said, Clayne, I've got a big box of Kleenex.
I feel like this person should have said, I've got a big box of Kleenex.
Kleenex. I love that. And this person obviously made their name based on Clayne. So you deserve a shout out on Hit Us Up. And make sure you guys keep leaving us comments. Hit us up when we ask questions on Twitter and everything. And we might just feature one of your comments on the show.
Which airs Monday through Friday, every single week. Rain or shine, Dana and I will be here holding it down.
We will.
Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you guys tomorrow.
Bye, guys.